Namaste, this is Sherline Vaz with the Vaz Harwood team. I'm very excited to present to you our latest listing in Powderhorn Park. This is 334 Bloomington Avenue, and this magnificent house has 5 bedrooms, 3 bathrooms, and a wonderful huge porch. I can't wait to show you. There are so many amazing things about the house. Wait till you ooh and ah over the amazing woodwork throughout. Come on in. I am so excited to show you this house. One of the magnificent features of this beautiful home is this large porch. Look at how huge it is. It's long, it's wide. There's enough room to dance if you want to. Yes. It's really that big, and you can look out, you can say hi to your neighbors, there's so much light flooding in. It's absolutely perfect and glorious. Let's check out the rest of the house, and you guys are in for a treat. Ta-da! Here we are. This house belongs to a very sweet friend of mine and her husband. They have done so many great things with this home. Just a quick back history. This house used to be a duplex, then it was converted back into a single family home. That's why it's very unusual to find a South Minneapolis home in Powderhorn Park, which has 5 bedrooms, 3 baths, and that has everything restored. So the Mr. Seller loves working with wood. So you'll notice all the woodwork is in exquisite condition and shape, just because this wonderful couple made it a point to restore the wood, oil it, as you know, old wood, to keep it in its peak condition. It always needs to be oiled. So typical of South Minneapolis homes, gorgeous, stunning, large windows. Look at all the woodwork everywhere. Something to note about all the radiators, the sellers have done little cute, clever inbuilts throughout the house over all the radiators just to make it more functional. For instance, this has a nice little bench on top, which their children and cat love to use to just sit up here and look out. I wanted to also point out the windows. These are all original to the house still, no cracks at all. And entering, so this is the living room area. Entering into the dining room area, check out this magnificent buffet. How amazing is it? So apparently it used to be stained due to sunlight and just years of hardware. And Mr. Seller, again, is brilliant with woodworking, and he's restored the entire thing magnificently. So this is oak. The floors are beautiful maple, and it's just glossy and lovely. Entering in here from the dining room, this is bedroom number one. Look at how lovely this is. Again, I love that there's something on top of the radiator here. Usually there are plants kept out there. I love that they have cleverly put in a piece of marble on top out here. And entering to the space, this is actual tile down here. So there used to be linoleum. It was replaced by beautiful tile. And I love how cleverly the sellers extended the tile from the main corridor into the bathroom, because it makes the bathroom look so much larger. They've restored everything. This is the linen cabinet, which is original to the house. I love how cute everything is. They've replaced it with newer hardware. But please note the radiator, how they have again built a box around it and made it more functional. So if you need to just put some plants out there or even get your towels warmed up, that's a very, very fun way to do it. This is really pretty cool. So According to Mrs. Seller, she calls this the cubby area where the kids come home from school and they place their school bags, they hang their coats out here, etc. Everything is at the height of the children. But back here is the radiator. So each and every radiator in this house has been made to look, to be completely functional. It's not just dead space out there. One of my favorite rooms, the kitchen. How many of you have ever seen such a large kitchen in a South Minneapolis home? Look at this, this is magnificent. So this bank of cabinets are original to the house. This amazing table stays with the house, with the kitchen. Why? Because it was built over the radiators. Look at that. Remember, I keep telling you, they built all the cubby areas, the tables, etc., so that they could better use the radiators. And yes, all this built-in furniture is staying with the house. The kitchen floor was created by Mr. Seller. He's used reclaimed maples. That's why there are so many different sizes and different pieces all over. Ceilings are high and lovely with so much light coming in. I absolutely adore this. And I like this farm style sink, kitchen sink. Bedroom number two is right here. And this is absolutely lovely. The two windows. So the steps that you see at the back to the window out here is the, remember I told you this house used to be a duplex? So that was, that's the other entrance from outside. Even though the cellars don't use it, those steps are still functional. But they keep the doors locked all the time. So let's check out the upstairs. So as I head upstairs, I just thought I would quickly point. This is the door where, which would be the other entrance from outside for people coming in. Remember, again, this used to be a duplex, but the cellars have just wisely chosen to keep it as is. These two areas are closet spaces, and this house has so much storage, but this is part of the storage system in here. Here's the magnificent bathroom. I love there are two sinks in here for both spouses to use. It's the whole bathroom is relatively new, and it's just so modern and spacious. Here's the main bedroom. So this is bedroom number three. However, this is the main bedroom. There are two closets on either side. And yes, look at how large this is. It's so wonderful. I love all the light coming in. Bedroom number four is right here. It's so cute. So this used to originally be a kitchen for the upper duplex apartment, and then our sellers restored it completely and turned this into a lovely bedroom for their child. And this area is bedroom number five. Yes, we've gotten this professionally measured, and this is a legal bedroom just because of the ceiling height. But this area right now is being used as a reading nook and a play area by the children. And it's just so fun. I love the light coming in from there and through the skylights. It just adds so much more dimension and space to the whole room. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys. This was done by Mr. Seller. Again, remember I told you he is obsessed with woodworking, but he's mixed in wood of different type all over here create a very fun looking space. I love this. It's butch. I love the basement. The basement is magnificent and it's huge. And if you decide you want to use a contractor to just move pipes anywhere and everywhere to finish it completely, that's equity building potential. So this is the basement, or part of the basement. Yes, it's really that huge and large. I love how everything is wonderfully spaced, but check this other room out. Remember I told you we have a large basement? So this is where the mechanicals are cleverly placed. And here is the entire work area where Mr. Seller works. He literally, this is his station, and it's pretty fun because he can do so much. I absolutely love this house, and I think it shows on my face. This here is the third bathroom. So the shower is out here. The commode is placed here, and there is no door. But we would rather, the sellers just said that they would rather the new buyers finish it however they choose to. Put in a door, make it, finish it more professionally, just get that done. However, so the plumbing and all is in place. It's all been permitted at all, etc. Okay? This room is where Mr. Seller works. So even though it's technically unfinished, it's beautiful, it's very warm, it's fun. There's plenty of head clearance, so you can get this professionally finished if you want to. Yeah, you're in the backyard. This garage is relatively new. It was built in 2017. It's a two-car garage. There's ample space up there for even more storage. And the sellers just said that they have had the time of their life just having fun with their new garage. And please note, there's extra space to park outside as well in case you have guests. We are right here on the deck. This is wonderful. This is a wonderful area to eat, have your meals, have breakfast, just hang out with the kids. And it's just so nice. I love that they have little planter beds too to grow veggies. So in case you know of anyone looking to move to South Minneapolis, please let us know. We would love to show them this home, or you could share this video with them. This is 334 in Bloomington Avenue, on Bloomington Avenue in South Minneapolis, in the Powderhorn neighborhood, one of my favorite neighborhoods. And it's me, Chevrolet Vaz, on the Vaz Harwood team. Namaste.